As you can see, I'm a professional tablet and smartphone musiker. The Digi Ensemble is something that is about 3 years ago. This time I had my first iPod Touch with iOS, and there I made some things with it, and there comes some sound, and this little gadget with its playful character, yeah, seems to be a little bit more than children's play. So I decided to make a group, an ensemble, with other musicians to prove how to make music with this. And today we have a good ensemble, the Digi Ensemble Berlin, and we have a lot of concerts. Tomorrow we will play in Munich. And today I want to give you a little short insight in my point of making music with apps. First I want to show you just a short sample with a video so you can see how it works with iOS devices, and but this is only video with iOS. Then I will show you Android music. Okay, now I will make something with the sound. So, right. So, this is one of our last projects we made from Bach, Christmas Oratorio in the Berlin Cathedral in December. And this is a professional produced video. And as you can see, every note is played in real time. Now I'm playing the solo trumpet. And the other musicians are playing just the notes of violin and viola and contrabass and so on. And our projects are with very good musicians here. Tobias Bernd is a well-known singer, and in the in Berlin Cathedral we made it with a star baritone, Roman Trekel. So we have a lot, but we don't only play classical music. In the ensemble are also some guys who are DJs, and in the ensemble are also some guys who are rock musicians and playing heavy drums and so on. But in the ensemble, like me as an opera singer, I'm playing the solo trumpet, and the heavy metal guitarist then plays the first violin and so on. And this is the very interesting thing, and we prove how to make it. Okay. Now we come to Android. I have a lot of iPods and iPads and so on, and make there my things. But since 1 year, I think so, I have this Nexus 7, I don't have an iPhone because I don't really like Apple. I can't do something because the iOS is, as you will see, much better for making music, but for communication and for me, I don't like really Apple. So I have no iPhone. I have also a Samsung Galaxy. And for research, I do also have this Windows 8 tablet, but there are only a few apps, and this are not good. All right, today I want to give you a short summary. That means my point of view, and then I will give you a short overview about the apps. For Android, there are about 500 in the category in the App Store, Android Play. And then I want to show you some things around the apps, hardware and APIs, and the sensors I want to tell you. And then I come to the real dismissal state of Android, because it's about the latency issue. Okay, so we start, and the summary is right. I'm working with Android yeah, really every day, as you can see. And this as Nexus is also my companion at home, because I'm reading and I'm communicating with this and not with iOS devices, to be ever in touch and to have this to understand it better. But I want to make some music in real time, and this is really complicated because of the latency. So there are only a few apps for me as a more academic classical musician to make music. I've also a background as a rock musician, and I play drums a long time, and I played bass guitar and so on. But this electronical things are not really my thing. I'm getting is with this gadget. And these are more the things you can do with this, because some this kinds of step sequences thing, there are some, and you can use it. And it's also a good tool as to show maybe the chords for the guitar, or to have a metronome to have the beat and so on. This is good, but it will take a very long time for making music. And with this, you can do it with the iOS gadgets. But I hope that I can inspire you to make something that this gadget will get an instrument, because my dream is that everyone has a smartphone or a tablet in his pocket. And I want to make this into an instrument, that everyone has an instrument in his pocket, and so it couldn't be only for iOS. Okay, now I give you a little overview. And because I'm a scientist and I'm looking for this in a very specific way, I have other categories just for the apps you can find in the category audio and music, I think, is it in Play Store. So there are a lot of music player apps that don't really interest me, because I don't want to hear music. I don't want to have some, sagen wir mal, auswählen something to find something. I want to really make music, so they don't really interest me. And then there are some fun apps, like you can talk and the app makes some rap of it, or generates something music. And generative music is a special thing that that makes you make a gesture and then it will produce some sounds. That is interesting, but that's not my way. And the other mobile music making apps, or as I call them, the kind of app music, is different, because you really interact with musical things. And this are the next eight categories are the categories where I can sort all these apps. For iOS, there are about 12,000 apps in the category of music. 12,000, and in the last eight, there are about 1,500. For Android, it's different. There are about 500 in the category music and audio, and for mobile music making, or for app music, there are only about 60. So it's much, also 60 apps, you can really do something. Okay, now let's start. I think I will go through here. These are the players, player apps. I think some of them you know, radio apps and player apps. Here we have the generative apps, for example, the Smule apps. Magic Piano, for instance, you can make collaborative or community-based some music for people who really like only touching and then sounding. And then I decide for sound toys. It sounds a little bit as if this really wouldn't good apps, but I want to show you some of them, because some of them are really interesting and others are not. The ones who I don't find really interesting are the apps who are very, very similar to real instruments. So I push this button. Okay, and as you can see, there is a trombone. Ah, but it's... But it comes... Ah, this way. It's a trombone, and now I use this and this trombone. And I can play, and I've forgotten how to make it more... Oh, I got it. Okay, now you can see what I can see. And there are the notes, and you can pull this. And what you can't see is that I'm doing something like this. This like on the violin, you can see that they're pushing this way, this 4-3 vibrato. And you can do this with this by shaking the hand. But as you can see, it's very difficult to play because this system is... I was wondering, why are the steps so different to guitar, to a piano? But this is really the Naturtonreihe, as I got on the university when asking some trumpet players. It's not really playful. It sounds complicated. You get in touch with an instrument, but not more. When you're looking in the App Store, you find a lot of apps like this one with black and white keys. Yeah, okay. Okay, this one. But the problem on this is when I'm playing this. Well, it works when you are only doing this, as I did it, but you can't really play because then you have this problem of latency. I will come later on. I'm touching on a glass thing, and I don't have this tasten, this keys to know where I'm playing. And I had piano Unterricht lessons. Thank you. Lessons for about 10 years, and you can't hear it because it's it's not playable because I don't play it. It's by one. But it doesn't play this. And this problem I have with all these black and white, I name them black and white apps. And the problem is that this is only such very small keys, and I don't really get it to play on this. So it's only a sound toy, something you can't really have really fun or to do something with it. With this, the same is with the drum apps. There's some drum kit and you can play it, but it's not the way a real drum kit where you can really play with your whole body and so on. And guitars where the strings are waving, why there is nothing waving, and so you feel very uncomfortable. Okay. This apps, this third category, I really like, because this app, I do in this category this apps that are doing something new, and the first one I want to show you is this one. Yeah, it's Notebeat, and Notebeat is something new because it doesn't look like an instrument you know. And it works this way, that you have this dots, and you can put other puts in around, and then you can make some very intuitively do some music. Can you make the music a little bit louder? And you can also do some rhythm things. And you don't need to know some how to read notes and so on. And you can really do interactive this music, and you can turn it off, and you can build it new by tapping it. That's not really cool. Maybe you can. They have different colors, so I know what they're doing. And the other cool thing is that in the background there are slightly lines you can play. You can play in real time to this beat. This way to interact with such a digital device, I like more than this black and white things. On iOS devices, there and these others have their own. Maybe I show one other. This one. It's also very well known from iOS. Okay. Okay, and this works this way. Also, I have an XY coordinate system, and where I put my fingers, I can make some sounds, and there are a lot of different sounds. And I can make some characteristic with the sound by changing. And there are a lot of. You can't really play with this Bach, but it's something that makes you. I think that is more interesting for making music, and so you can, search for your music, and you don't need to have any notes and so on, just by clicking. Okay. Beside that, there are musical tools, and they are really good for maybe the metronome tempo is very interesting, and you don't need to have all your sheets with you. iRealBook maybe is a collection of RealBook things, either the chords for playing with the guitar, and you have them all with you. A big years ago you had such a big book, now you have it on this, and it plays for you the bass and the drums, and so you don't play for you alone, you can play like a little band and so on. Okay, these are musical tools. There are, I think you can read it what it is. This Beatmaker apps is very interesting for Android, because as I already mentioned, it's not really a real-time based music. Here you can program some music. So I will see whether I can show to you. Okay, I will switch. And for instance, there's no, I don't want to show this one. I want to show maybe this one. And here you can see it's always. And no, that's too big. So I take something different, and here we take this one, and here you can program something, and now we have the kick drum, and where it's highlighted with. Now we don't have a kick drum, and it ever plays in a loop. And so I don't have to be, it don't have to be in real time. That was a bass at the beginning. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4. So you can program something and it plays around. And you can make also will stop it. You can also make some patterns, and you can then change the patterns so it doesn't really, it's this simple loop. You can make it really very complex with more instruments and so on. But as you can see, it ever is loop-based. And there are really a lot you should have a look at. And then there are some apps where you can, oh, you can't see it. And then there are some apps where you can do some audio things. That's not really is it as in an as by iOS, because it's not built in Android. So you need, the app must have the drivers for the, your device. For example, I bought a Zoom N4, H4N, and this one you can then with a connection kit you can put on this, and then you can start an app like this one, and you can record it. So you can't see it, and then you can record it. Looks like that. Very simple, but this is as I have seen, the only one who can do this. Also with simple USB drivers to make audio recorder digitally connect with Android. And then there are a lot of sequencer programs that look a little more. I don't want to show this one. This one. They are more complex, like this one, and then you can really do some recording with more tracks than one. But this app doesn't, up to now, have these drivers for the program. So you have to put your music or your recordings into it by email and per Exchange menu. All right, and then there are also some loopers, like this one. Also, looper is something very interesting for this device. I will show a short video. So,
hello, Rich here from Single Cell Software, and I want to show you LoopStack, my metronome.
Here's the recording one by another.
Let's record another loop right now.
So you can make your own band. There are really tricky things around this, where one guy is making a whole band by himself, only by voice, and who is up to 16 of these lines, and it's really crazy, and you can really do something very interesting with this. For Android, there are some loopers. I think about three are interesting. Not more for Android. For iOS, there are about, I don't know, 50. So that's the problem. Okay, the next one category is MIDI, and it's about controllers. That means you can control a big machine, a big mixer with it over Wi-Fi. That's very interesting. Or you can use this device for playing another instrument. That's really interesting. And it seems for me, as if this OC thing doesn't have this latency. You know that via Wi-Fi there must be some latency, but this was much shorter than on the original device. So it's maybe it was my feeling, but it was I will have a more look to this, because it seems so. Okay, then the next thing I think you will like, because it's den Ton, because it's very easy and very intuitive to use. It's about to handle with with material, and it's more easy, and so I like it. And this is, for example, this one. So, and I have to. Okay, changes. So, and you can do. By this, you have the stems, and where you're putting it, it sounds different. We have now the organ, and now we have the applause. Now. And it's, as you can see, very useful, and it's very funny to make it with two persons, because you don't have four, you can't listen really to four of these stems, and in iOS there are also some apps like this one, there you have up to six of these stems, and you can play it by fourth. So, but yeah, as you can see, it's very easy, and there is some music, and yeah, it's very playful. And I will show one other, because maybe you say, hey, what this music? It sounds ever very good. Yeah, this is the thing of remixing and DJing, and this, you only make decisions, but you make musical decisions. And this app is called SPC, Sketch Music, and here you start some samples, and you can and it is time based or beat based, so we can you can make your own beats in this, and then you can. And yeah, as you can see, it's very easy to make music. Yeah, very easy. So, and I think the last category is synthesizers. This synthesizer category is something interesting because, yeah, it's a digital device, and it's about generating sound. It generates sound, but you can't really control it because of the latency thing. Yeah, there are some very interesting synthesizers. For instance, maybe. This one, you can see, this one, where you can make the shape of a sound, and then we have to play it, and then we need a key to play it, but I don't have the key now. Or is it possible? No. Ah. And what you're listening to is really the sound of this shape. So when we draw something different, it sounds different. Wait, may I make so? It's it's not this the way I want to show to you, because maybe you can take something different. There are some cool apps, but they are a little bit complex now to show you. I think I will put these slides in the internet, and then you can have your look to it. So, last two things are this Ton is this app because of its idea of collaboration. I really like. It's also step-based and has some synthesizer things in it. I want to show you. shot. And I have this app, it really works. It's ever you are in one session, and then you are programming or recording, and when you leave this one screen with this one session, then another session will be made, and the sessions are then synchronized. Okay. And the other thing is other app I really like, I don't know whether you know, AudioTool. It's a web-based sound platform. And this very popular platform is also available as an app, but not for my device. It's for other devices, for other tablets, but not for the Nexus 7. So developers, please take it on my device. It's also electronic music, and as you can see, step sequencer things, but they really are very complex and very interesting tool, and they have a lot of effects, engines, and so on. It's very cool thing, and it's not much. So it would be a good job for Android to have this. Okay, now I come to the second part. On Android, there are only a few apps that you can use in multitasking. That means if you go to another app, then it stops the one app and you can use the other apps. For iOS, it's very common that you can play some other apps in background. As I mentioned already before, I'm on iOS, I always use three apps at one time, one for the sound, one for the controlling things because of motion control, and one for the interface. So it's not for Android, it's not really possible. There are only a few apps like this one in this video you can use by side and then that play together, but there is no synchronization. And this is also possible in iOS, that you can sync several apps on one device, and you can sync apps on different devices. So it is a must for making music. Now there are also some manufacturers who are interested in Android, like Aika Multimedia. They are making some microphones and adapters for these gadgets. That aren't really only for hobby musicians, but yeah, now they have their first app for Android. For iOS, I think they have nearly 20 very complex samplers and synthesizers. But maybe this is the beginning of going to Android. This is a video where you can see how they put this Zoom H4 on the Galaxy. And there are also some effect apps, so you can play guitar and you can put it into the device, and then you have your fat your rock sound. It's possible to play with MIDI keyboards, this app. Some apps, but as you can see, we have all we have this latency problem. So when he
this is a quick instruction to mail micro USB.
So when he plays,
so that means whatever is currently on screen, that includes its pattern editor. So if I switch, you can switch instruments by dragging.
It's fast, but it's not fast enough. All right, and then there are also possibilities, and that's not possible on iOS, that you can control something via Bluetooth. One app is it, and it's more useful, as I already mentioned, to take touch or the OSC protocol, which is the controlling protocol like MIDI, but much more. Leistungsfähig. Yeah, sensors. Sensors. There are some sensors on iOS. I really use a lot of sensors because I don't really like to touch this yeah, glass thing. When I'm making music, it's always the way that I'm holding my instrument this way, and then I have here my interface. Maybe this one that looks a little like a guitar for me, maybe not now for you. And then I'm playing this with one hand, with the other hand I'm waving it around. So when I'm doing this, the volume increases, and when I'm doing this, it gets down. And so I can play like on a cello. I can make some crescendo. Lauter werden, leiser werden, and so on. And then I'm playing this way, and so on. And there are more directions, so I can make a cut off or some quality of the sound with this movement. And so it really becomes an instrument for me. And as you have seen in the video, also for other people, and so on. And it's really interesting for musicians because it's in real time. It's very Es hat ja genug Stärken, ist sehr leistungsfähig, um wirklich Musik zu machen. An accelerator and a gyroscope is also available on these devices. And I got one. I will take the sound. One device, one app that really makes it in this way, and I want to show you. So you have it's this, how's it called? Now I can't find it. Mist. Ah, this one. Okay. Okay, and here we have a motion controller in it. Can you make it much louder? Much louder? Much? It's a little like this one I had before. You can't really see this semitones and so on, but these are the strings. And you can see the latency. And that's not playable. But I want to show you the motion control. Wait. Have you ist da irgendwie ein Kompressor drauf? Okay, there's no compression on it, but I thought it. Yep. I think I have to say two things. There is a motion sensor, and maybe I will make it on afterwards. And you can also see this in this video. Okay, latency issue is a big problem, and that I want. You have seen there are some videos that make this Vergleich on iOS and Android, and there you can really see the problem. And when you are playing drums, then some notes you can't hear, and so on. They are hidden, and so that's a problem. And there's a big discussion. Sonoma gets its own special drivers for that problem, but it's not really on every smartphone. You have to use your own. Then ask some developers why are there such a few musical apps, and they say that it's very problematic for them to make apps for Android because there are about 40 devices to test on, and the market isn't that way. But in about 2 days they will release this app, Fruity Loops Studio. That's a well-known musician app on computer and on iOS, and now it will come to this platform. And as you can see, it's also step-based, but it's very comfortable for this thing and sounds very good. So we will have there a little more very good apps. So I think that was it. Yeah, this was it. And now we can make a discussion Just ask me.
Okay, first of all, round of applause.